I'm Ilyan, and in this video, we're going to take a quick look at how to maintain and backup your MeshCentral server. There's a lot of things that are tripping up people when they configure their server, when they back up their server. And so we're going to take a look at those topics today. So when you set up your own MeshCentral server, first of all, it's super important that you keep a backup offsite of your server. And there's a couple of files that are super important to back up. So let's first take a look at the directory structure of MeshCentral. So let's suppose I install my own MeshCentral server and I have it running, like for example, right here. And okay, I have it running, but what's going on in the background? Well, there's commonly these four folders that will be created. The first one, node modules, is the executable of your MeshCentral server. It contains all the executable files and the default resources and so on. This doesn't contain any of your own data. So you can replace this folder anytime by a new version and it should work fine. So one idea, for example, is to rename this node modules underscore back, and then you go into, you open the command prompt, you would go into that folder, and then you could do npm install MeshCentral again, and this would create a new version of node modules, and then you would be able to run your server. And as long as you keep all the other directories here, your server will run just like before, right? So all the machines, all the accounts, or so on, they will run just fine. The other nice thing about doing that is if something goes wrong, you can just take this old node modules, put it back, and then run the old server back again, okay? So the other thing to note is that if you do any customization to the server, like you want, you're changing graphics or images or stuff like that. Some people do want to do that. The problem with doing it inside this folder is that as soon as you update to a new version of MeshCentral, all those changes will be lost. So typically you don't want to change anything inside this folder unless you expect to lose it on the next update. Now, the other folders are interesting. MeshCentral files contains the user files of this folder. So if you go to MeshCentral and you go to My Files, this is server-side files that when you upload here, it uploads on the MeshCentral server, and actually those files are kept in the MeshCentral files folder. And so you see, for example, user admin and public and so on, and this is where you'll find the files for here. Now, actually, this server is not this one, but you get the idea. Okay, now the other one that's interesting is MeshCentral backups. By default, MeshCentral will do a backup every 24 hours of its own MeshCentral data folder and its own database. If you're using Mongo, it will attempt to do a backup of the Mongo database plus the MeshCentral data folder. If you're using an EDB, of course, the default database that comes with MeshCentral, then all the database is here, so MeshCentral just does a backup of that. So every 24 hours, you get a new backup here. It's really prudent to grab this occasionally and save it offsite so that if the server crashes or something, you have a full backup, you can restore your server completely. Now, the most important folder by far is the MeshCentral data folder. This contains the initial database. This is the database if you're using an EDB. If you're using Mongo, MySQL, MariaDB, then the database is obviously somewhere else. But if you're using the built-in MeshCentral database that comes from the start, then the DB files are right here. Then you have your configuration file. This is where you have hundreds of options to customize your MeshCentral server. You have your certificate files, and there's four certificates here. And those are super important, especially the top one here, the agent and the root one. These, if you lose them, all the agents you've installed will forever refuse to connect to the server. So this certificate is used to authenticate you, your server, and all the agents you set up, they will demand that the server verify that it has this certificate here before they accept to connect. Okay, so super important you back this up. There's also a server state file. This the server writes into this when it starts and stops with the process ID and its current running state and stuff, and can be used for automation of a couple of things. But the most important is the config.json file. So let's take a look at that file. And I'm going to use Visual Studio here to take a look at the config file. And so by default, the config file is really dummy. And actually, no values here are used. But it gives you a basic template to start editing your config. So there's a settings section. There's a domain section. And then there's other sections like Let's Encrypt, for example. Now, every key that starts with an underscore is ignored. So if meshcentral were to look at this file right now, this section starts with an underscore, so it's not useful. All these start with an underscore, so they're not useful. This is not useful. And the schema is actually not useful either. So you basically have this file. So by default, the config file actually has nothing in it, right? But it's useful as a template. So for example, if you want to change the title bar, like this mesh central on top left here, you want to change it to your own server name, you uncomment this line and you would say my server, for example, and next time you run, my server will show up in here. And then you can do things like minify, allow new accounts. You can, for example, change the port of your server if you want to run it on an alternate port. And if you want to specify a DNS name for your server, you do it here. And this key is very important because the name of your server will dictate the name that all the agents will use to connect back to the server. If you don't specify this, by default, the agents will multicast, try to find your server on the local network and connect to it. But most serious servers will have a DNS name, and so this is where you set it. Okay. Eventually, you'll want to, for example, add Let's Encrypt support. You would remove this underscore, put your email, put the DNS name or names that you want to request for Let's Encrypt. You start by production equal false, make sure everything's okay. And then once it's running, you put production equal true, and meshcentral will renew your TLS certificate every 45 days automatically. The settings sections here, there's many more settings. Those are usually global to the entire server. You can create multiple domains. I won't go too much into the detail, but you can set up like customer two, and now you have we can set up a separate title for them, my server number two. So here you would have a server with two different domains, and each domain would have its own set of users, its own administrators, its own user groups, and so on. And you can customize the domains completely separately. So this allows you to have a single meshcentral server with many different facing domains for different customers, for example, if that's what you want to do. Now, most people will just have one domain. So you have that, and you can continue configuring. Now, if you want an idea of a more advanced configuration, inside the node modules, so you would have to go node modules, mesh central. There's this file here, setup config advanced. And so if you open it, you will see an advanced version of the configuration file with just crazy amounts of settings, like MongoDB, pings, like restrictions on IP addresses, Like, there's just so many different things. Customization of the pictures on the login screen and so on. Just crazy amounts of stuff. So you can customize Mesh Central really the way you want it for your own use. The last thing I want to mention is, of course, backups. I want to finish with that. There's one thing I want to do is talking about the config file here. A lot of people get tripped because they start editing the config file and they don't realize they're not JSON compliant anymore. And Mesh Central is very picky on how you do your JSON. So for example, if you add a comma at the end here, this is at the end of a line that doesn't have another line in that section, and that's invalid, right? So Mesh Central will complain and say this is not a parsable file. So if you want to know that your JSON is parsable, of course you could use an editor that edits JSON like Visual Studio, or you can cut and paste your JSON. Go into DuckDuckGo, type JSON lint on the search bar, and this will bring you up to this box here where you can paste your JSON and it will tell you, whoop, this is not valid. Then I can remove the comma here, click again, and it will say this is valid, right? So just make sure you're writing correct JSON. A lot of people kind of have a problem editing this file at first because it's a little bit bizarre and it's very picky. But once you get the hang of it, it shouldn't be a problem at all. So anyway, that's the configuration and that's how to parse it. For backing up, make sure you either back up the Mesh Central data, you also back up the database, or you grab one of these auto backups regularly and put them offsite. Hopefully, this video would have helped. There's so many more stuff to cover, and we'll cover in other videos in the future. But for now, thank you very much. Have a nice day.